Alright, fifth graders, today we are working on lesson 7.9, which is multiply mixed numbers. So if you take a look at page 325, our word problem is 1/3 of a 1 1/4 acre park has been set aside as a dog park. Find the number of acres that are used as a dog park. Alright, so I'm going to show you two different ways that you could solve this problem. So we are looking for 1/3 of 1 1/4. Okay, we know already, we learned, if we see the word of, it means we are multiplying, so we have 1/3 times 1 1/4. So the first way I'm going to show you how to do this problem is by using a model so we can visually see what it is we are doing. All right, so my total area is 1 1/4. So that's the model I'm going to start with. I'm going to use rectangles to represent the park. I know I'm going to need two because I have one whole and a fourth. Okay. Now I know I'm working with fourths, so I'm going to divide these into fourths. I know 4/4 is equal to 1. So my one whole is going to be these 4/4. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, 4/4. There's my one whole. And then I have 1/4. Okay, so there's my 1/4. Now I need to find 1/3 of this 1 1/4. So now I'm going to divide these models. I'm going to go the opposite direction by thirds. There's 1, 2. There's 1 and 2. Okay, so now I have thirds. And I need to find 1/3 of 1 1/4. So remember, what I have colored in pencil already is showing me 1 1/4. So now I need to find 1/3 of what I have colored. So here is 1/3 of my whole, and here is 1/3 of my 1 1/4. Okay. So now I need to ask myself, how many parts are in this and how many parts are in here? So when I divided it into fourths and then thirds, I ended up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 parts. Okay, so both pieces, both wholes, now have 12 parts. They have 12 pieces. Okay? So I need to take a look at this one and see, when I found 1/3 of the whole, how many pieces had I colored in? Well, I had 4 that overlapped. So that gave me 4 out of those 12 pieces. Okay? And then when I looked over here, I had 1 out of the 12 pieces. So now if I add these two together, that's going to tell me what 1/3 of 1 1/4 is. I already have a common denominator, so I can add my numerators. 4 plus 1 is 5. My denominator is 12. So 5/12 has been set aside for the dog park. So 5/12 is 1/3 of 1 1/4. Okay, so that's one way to do it, showing it on a model. A second way to do it is by using a fraction that's greater than 1. Okay, so I have the same problem, 1/3 times 1 1/4. So I can turn this 1 1/4 into a fraction that is greater than 1. And that way I'll just be able to multiply straight across. So I'm going to bring down my 1/3 because that one's going to stay the same. I'm going to turn this into a fraction greater than 1. So I'm going to multiply my denominator by my whole number, and I'm going to add my numerator. So 4 times 1 is 4, plus 1 is 5. So I have 5/4. Okay, 5/4 is equal to 1 1/4. So now I can just multiply straight across. 1 times 5 is 5. 3 times 4 is 12. And here is my answer. And as you note, they are the same. Okay? So regardless if you use a model or if you use a fraction greater than 1, you'll end up with the same answer because you are doing the same mathematics, the same calculations. All right, and if you look at page 326 in your book, they're showing you 2 other ways you could do this. These 2 problems happen to have a whole number in them. So example 1 has 12 times 2 1/6. Okay, the numbers are, I think, got a little bit bigger, so it looks like a whole number. There we go. Okay. So for this first example, they're telling you could rename this whole number. Last week we had heard that we can put 12 over 1 and it would be the same as 12. Okay, a whole number over 1 is still showing that whole number, right? Because a fraction, you want to think of it in terms of, it's a division problem. So if we did 12 divided by 1, we are still going to get 12, okay? That is the reasoning behind why you can put any whole number over 1 and it still represents that whole number. It has not changed, okay? So you can just take that and put the whole number over 1. And then continue from there. And in this particular example, they changed this mixed number into a fraction greater than 1. Okay, so this one was example 1. And then example 2, they have just used the distribution property, which we have learned before. Okay, so this one we started with 16 times 4 1/8. And so using the distribution property, they started by breaking this apart. So we've got 16 times 4 plus 1/8. Okay, because this is 4 1/8, or 4 plus 1/8. So now in this step, we're just breaking that apart. So now comes the distribution part. We're going to distribute 16 times 4 and 16 times 1/8. So we can do 16 times 4 plus 16 times 1/8. All right, and then you would just solve this straight through. 16 times 4 is 64. Keeping in mind, we can do 16 over 1 times 1 over 8. My 64 stays the same. 16 times 1 is 16. 1 times 8 is 8. I'm going to simplify this by turning it back into what would be a mixed number. I know 8 goes into 16 2 times without going over, and actually 2 times 8 is 16, so I know I'm not going to have anything left once I do that. So I have 64 plus 2, so my answer will be 66. Okay, so that's how they were doing example 2. So these are just a few different ways that you can multiply mixed numbers by showing it in a model, so visually showing what you have done, by changing the mixed number to a fraction greater than 1, and then multiplying. This one, example 1, I did not work all the way through it, but it was showing if you have a whole number that we can put that over 1 and it is the same number. And then continuing with that example, it's turning this into a fraction greater than 1. And then example 2 was just showing you how to do that using the distributive property.